Hi, welcome to the channel. My name is DJ, and what we're going to be doing today is starting a tutorial series on Behringer's newest console, the Wing. In this series, we're going to have multiple different videos, starting in this one with just the console overview, so the layout and the I/O options that you get on the console itself, moving into some more complex videos such as the routing options that you can do, some of the new features that it has, and the different settings that you can change within the console. So let's get started. First up, we'll look at the console layout. So like most new digital consoles, we have our screen. This one is an upgrade for Behringer since it's a larger screen and it's touchscreen, so you can touch through all the different menus. Directly to the right of that, we have our channel processing area. This is also a new layout for Behringer, as on the X32 series, we had different sections for EQ, dynamics, and gain. This one combines all of those into one area, and you use different buttons to select the attributes. So, up next is the custom controls section. It's directly below the channel processing area, and we get 4 encoders and 8 buttons. But what's the upgrade over the X32 and M32 series is we get 16 layers that we get to customize each 4 encoders and 8 buttons. Moving on to the faders. This is a new design for Behringer, whereas instead of just the 2 sections of faders plus the master fader, we now have 3 sections, and where the master fader used to be, we now have 4 faders with layers. So let's start on the left side. So we have our 1 through 12 inputs, 13 through 24, 25 through 36, 37 through 40, and our aux ins. Just below that, we have our bus masters that we can view on this side as well, and then 2 user definable layers that we can set up in a later video. Moving on to the center, we of course have our DCAs, we have our matrixes, we have our aux ins that we can view on this side as well, and then our bus masters. But unlike the X32 and M32 series, we don't have 2 bus pages. We have these +4 and -4 buttons to view all 16 of our buses. So right now we're only looking at buses 1 through 8. If we tap this forward 4 button twice, we can see buses 9 through 16. And then just below that, we of course have 2 more user definable layers that we can set up in a later video. So now let's look at the master area. Instead of having only 1 master fader, we now have 4 faders with multiple different layers that we can choose from. So let's start up right up at the top. We have our main and matrix area that we can cycle through, our DCAs that we can cycle through, inputs that we can cycle through as well. Plus, for the inputs, we can adjust gain, phantom power, gate, compressor, and filter. Just below that is our aux ins. Below that is our bus masters. And then we also have 2 more user definable layers. These will be really useful if you want to have a money channel such as a lead vocal always on hand. So the last section we'll talk about is the monitoring and talkback area. Right up at the top is our USB audio and data. So you can play 2-track audio out from the USB, or you can save scenes or restore scenes to the console from there. Just below that, we have our talkback A and talkback B, which can be latched or unlatched, and their talk level. Just to the right of that, we have our headphone level. And then we have our monitor level for speakers coming off of the console itself. And we can dim those or mono sum those. To finish off this video, let's talk about the I/O options that we have on the console itself. To start, we have 8 XLR ins and outs. We have 8 quarter inch aux in and aux outs. And then we have 3 AES50 buses, which is an upgrade from the M32 and X32 series, which only had 2. So now let's move on to the expansion slot. When you buy the console, it comes pre-installed with the Wing Live card. This is a dual SD card slot that you can record or play back all your channels from. This can be useful for a situation like virtual sound check or recording all your channels to go back and mix later. Also on the console, we have a USB B port for using it as an interface, so you can record or play back audio from your computer. So that's gonna be it for this video. If you'd like to continue along with the tutorial, feel free to subscribe, and I'll have all the links down below, as well as a playlist that you can follow along with. So thanks, and see you in the next one.